This method can help answer key questions in the analytical chemistry, biochemistry, and biotechnology fields, such as what are the changes that occur in the caffeine biosynthesis.
The main advantage of this technique is that it can be applied to in vitro plant models that produce caffeine.
To begin, add 10 milliliters of acetone to the lyophilized cells and seal the flask before mixing with a vortex mixer for 30 seconds. Then, mix the sample at 100 RPM with a rotator for 5 hours at room temperature. After this, resuspend the sample with 25 microliters of acetone. First, apply 1 microliter of the previously prepared caffeine extract to the silica gel plates. Then, develop the TLC in the chromatography chamber with 10 milliliters of the mobile phase cyclohexane acetone. Visualize the caffeine bands in short wavelength ultraviolet with a compact UV lamp. After this, quantify caffeine levels by densitometry at 273 nanometers. Using filter paper, vacuum filter the previously prepared cell suspension. Then, use a porcelain mortar to macerate the cell sample with liquid nitrogen and RNA isolation reagent until it is homogenized. Next, transfer 500 microliters of the sample to a sterile microcentrifuge tube. Then, add 300 microliters of chloroform isolation.